right here on Urban Television. You're chilling on yet another edition with Anisha, with a tea. It's called One on One. If you're in a bar, or you're at a wedding, or you just like to chill, one of the songs that you usually play on your iTunes, and you hear the Wizzy on the beat, he's the very gentleman that is with me right here. I'm getting the chills, I can't believe it. We actually had a behind the scenes. If you know a gentleman called Bini Ganta, he's worked on his latest track. Welcome to the show, my dear.
Welcome.
I like your earrings.
Thank you.
Just to say they're unique. And I don't think if you remember this, but you came on XFM with Skills, and at that time I was still doing The Exit, and you were there, and we're having a live session with you. So this is the second time we're running. God is saying something to us.
Mm. One can I say? I'm very glad to be here. I had a very amazing interview for Urban TV recently about the making. And I'm glad you guys are hosting me again.
Yes. Yeah. We start off the show. People want to know your real name, first of all. Are you Wizzy on the beat? Or you're like Sechitoloke Edman? Or you're not even Ugandan per se?
I'm called Jonathan Wendy Gabriel by birth. The Wizzy on the beat is my stage name. Like, okay. As a producer, songwriter, music, sound engineer and all that. Right now I can say I'm Ugandan, but I was born in Congo, raised in Congo, then I came, and then I moved to Uganda.
You're Congolese?
Yeah, I'm Congolese.
Okay, that's beautiful. So, did you study this, or is it just a talent? Because, honestly speaking, the kind of work that you produce is, it seems more than talent. It's like you also, you studied about this, you understand? It's, you know, it's like, not only are you talented, but you know, Omanyichokola, do you speak a little Uganda? You understand?
I can understand some, but I don't speak.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is this just a talent, or it's something that you studied and you're good at it?
I didn't study production.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I just started in my bedroom, and I found myself become a music producer. Wow. And then, you know, in the process of doing something, you want to learn more, you understand? And then from there, I started getting, like, on internet, trying to learn more about what I'm doing, new approach in the music industry. Listen to what is going on, and you understand how I can approach them more in a better way to upgrade myself. Not
so
for some
you
other
said
people.
It from your room, now you're a big hit right now. Everybody has to get, if you don't have a beat by the Wizzy, then you're doing nothing in Uganda, basically. You're back to top. I'm telling you, Bini Ganta, you're back to almost every top artist, not only in Uganda, but also I hear internationally.
Yeah,
yes.
Trying.
Don't be shy. Are you camera shy?
I'm not camera shy, but I'm just trying, you know?
Be real.
Yeah.
So what are some of the international acts you've worked with?
I cannot mention the name because the music is not yet out, but I worked with some of them.
And
pretty sure, you know, like you cannot tell when they're going to release the music. But a couple of Nigerians that I've worked with, a couple of Kenyans. Recently I was in Kenya, and then I worked on some records, and I'm working with some Tanzanian right now.
Mm.
Congolese, you know, I'm Congolese, so that one is obvious.
It's obvious. Yeah. So now, let's talk about the musical journey. You know, you started from your room, and now you're a big hit. How did you start? How did you come up with a beat and convince someone? Did you just walk up to someone and be like, you know what, I am good at this? The connections, the journey. Was it an easy journey?
I cannot say it was an easy journey, but you know, every journey is different, differs from, you know, like your journey may be easy, to someone else is difficult.
Yes, that's
for me, my journey was difficult, but for someone who say it was easy, because I broke through the Ugandan industry, I cannot say in an easy way, but in a shorter time.
Yes.
From the time I came to Uganda and then started making music, I found people loving my production and all that, you know.
Mm.
I started, when I was in Uganda, when I came, I was still in a merchant production.
Mm.
And then people liked it, and then I found myself start giving out beats, you know, and more I got likes of Keko, Big Trill, Munji, and all those guys at the time. And then from there, I started now understanding my own sound, my own approach to the music, and then up to today. You know?
So through the journey, you've also learned how to grow in it.
Exactly.
You said something. You said. You worked with different acts like the Moonjis, and then you also sat down and recognized like this is the route I'm supposed to be taking. So it has also helped you grow in a way.
Yeah, because those guys at the time when I reached, there was someone in the industry. I was a nobody, you know. I could not speak English, so I could speak only my language, French and Lingala. So it used to be a little bit difficult to talk with them. But then, for me at the time, there were these guys they were selling. Keko was in Sony. Big Thrillers, where they had a big song. Moonji was all over and all that stuff. So many artists and producers that I was meeting. So it was a challenge because for me, I wanted to grow. I wanted to be on their pace because I felt like I'm not yet on the level they are. But so it's like, you know, you're just your thinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, by then I wanted to be better. So I concentrated more on making myself a better producer.
Like and you say, for you it has been not easy, but the breakthrough was, it didn't take a long time. You understand it?
Yeah, it didn't.
It wasn't that hard. Did you have like family behind you? Because you talked about the fact that you came here, you didn't even have to speak English. I'm learning. You must be fast at learning. Now you're speaking English.
Yeah, I'm fast at learning things.
Yeah. Do you have family here? Or you just got your suitcase, packed your bag, you're like, I'm going to a new destination, I'm starting off. Or do you have family here?
My family has always, they used to be against my music until this year. Okay. This year and last year. That's when they start supporting me musically. But you know, like I'm not really a family type of person. I'm more of a friend type of person.
What does that even explain that?
I'm not this type of person who wants to cry for something to happen. I make things happen by myself. You know, if I want something, if I don't know anything, I look for a way I'm going to approach it. Like, I came to Uganda, yes, I had somewhere to reach from. But the whole society where I reached from, it was Congolese. Like everyone you want to meet, they speak, you understand? They speak Lingala, either they speak English, either they speak French, either they speak, what's that language? French and Swahili. So it was a little bit difficult. So, you know, you cannot come in Uganda and you want to get along with Ugandans and you want to stay with a community that is like where you come from, you know, it's like impossible.
So you had to adjust naturally.
So I had to adjust.
Now your family is behind you. Now you're pulling in big bucks. It's like giving you lots of money, isn't it?
No, I don't need their money.
No, I'm not talking about your family money. I'm talking about the fact that now they're behind you. They see that you're bringing in hard work and the money is coming in.
You know, for me, it's only a simple thing. You know, it's not about money. It's not about getting something from someone. But it's only about you. You're my family. And then recognize that I love what you do. I'm supporting you. Even if you don't give me 1 shilling. But only that one for me, I feel better.
You feel good.
But the fact that you cannot support, like, and tell me, you know, that road that you're taking, there's so much drugs, there's so much prostitution, blah, 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 all those things, you know? Like, that doesn't work with me. You know, like, you know you're supposed to be an engineer because I draw, stuff like that. And then, for me, it didn't work out, you know? So I decided to distance myself from my family, follow my own passion. Then when it's working, then, you know, like, family is always family. You can never run out
of family. You can never. That's what I wanted to ask you. At the end of the day, you can choose your friends, you can't choose your family. But yeah, unfortunately, exactly. We have to take a quick break. But when we come back, we're going to talk about the height of your career. Because now you're at your peak. What are you going to get from that? What are you going to, how are you planning to keep at the top? You know, because there's so many people who rise and they fall. You understand? How do you plan to maintain that name? Like Beyonce and Jay-Z, that kind of thing. They'll always be at the top.
I don't think I'm there yet.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
Trust me, there's a lot we're going to catch up when we come back.
Sure.
Stay hooked.